If I put Delilah on the throne, the painting should trap her in her own fantasy world. Eliminate Delilah one way or the other. You wanted to rule a world of your own, Delilah? So be it. And now to see how well your magic works, Delilah. At last, what I've always deserved, my justice. Now, what's always been marred and distorted will be perfect. I've waited so long. Sing my song and lick my flesh. Worship me! Let's sit down. I'll explain it all.
Thank you. And so a man born with the face of the Duke took his seat in Karmaka, ruling with empathy for those not born in a palace. The people were surprised by this sudden turn, but did not question their good fortune. In Dunwall, without ever realizing it, Delilah passed into an imagined world where her father's promises were fulfilled and her subjects would love her forever, as she sailed the ocean with a great fleet and trekked across the Pendisian wastes. While in the true capital, Emily the Just, Emily the Clever, ruled for decades over a prosperous, mended empire with Corvo Atano by her side. In his day, Anton Sokolov fired the engines of industry, hurtling the empire into a more sophisticated age. He dallied with nobles, wayward artists, and great inventors alike, drinking in all that life could offer. Leaving Dunwall for the last time, he headed to the cold north, contented at last on a final voyage to take him home. There are things that never change, no matter how hard you try. Questions you must answer. As Megan Foster faded from the world, Billy Lurk stepped from her shadow, setting out to discover her truest self, and seeking the closest thing she'd ever known to family.
Until the evening ships sail, when the night is black.